The students of IET DAVV of Branch Information Technology, batch of 2021, are here to present our Smart Systems Lab project, which is a self-driving obstacle avoiding car. So the team consists of myself, Prerak Jain.
Myself, Varun Dev.
Myself, Palash Rakhe.
Shubham Singh.
And myself, Shreedhar.
Okay, so let's begin.
Hello friends, I am Palash Rakhe and I am going to explain you about the components which we are using in obstacle avoiding car. The first one is Mega Arduino, then motor driver shield, then ultrasonic sensor, servo motor, DC motor, chassis, tires, jumper wires and the adapter, and the software which we are using is obviously Arduino.
Hi, I'm Prerak and I'll be explaining about Arduino components and their connections. So starting out with Arduino Mega, the Arduino Mega 2560 is a microcontroller board based on AT2560 specification. It has 54 digital output pins, 16 analog pins, 4 hardware serial ports, a USB connection, a power jack and a reset button. Now let me show you the connections of the Arduino Mega board we have used in our car. So this is our Arduino Mega right here. As you can see, we have just connected an adapter to the power jack. No more direct connections are required. We just have to place a motor driver shield on top of it. So the analog pins of Mega corresponds to the analog pins of motor driver shield, and same is the case for digital and power pins. So let me connect. Okay, that was the connection. Now let us see the motor driver shield. Motor driver shield essentially controls and drives our DC motor and servo motor. As its name suggests, it drives the motor. Now it provides a bi-directional current to our motors, and its input voltage range is from 4.5 to 36 volts. Now let me show you the connections of the motor driver shield we have used in our project.
This is our motor driver shield placed right above on Arduino Mega. It consists of 4 power outputs for our 4 DC motors. Output number 1, 2, followed by 3 and 4. It also supply power to our servo motor as well as ultrasonic sensor. So there is one important thing to keep in mind is that while connecting the power supply to our DC motors, check priorly the terminals, otherwise the tire will move in opposite direction.
Now let's move on to another component, which is the DC motor. As all of you might be knowing that a DC motor converts the electric DC current into mechanical power. To be precise, whenever the DC current flows through the armature windings of a DC motor, it rotates in the presence of the magnetic field of the magnets present already in the DC motor. So now let us take a look at the 4 DC motors we have used in our project.
The 4 DC motors are placed right below the chassis. Each motor is a 12 volt motor and has an RPM of about 2400 RPMs. But we have set the RPM of each motor to about 1/3 of the original RPM, as the car would move very fast. So those were the DC motors.
Hi, I am Shyam Singh. In this project, we have used a DC power supply with the help of an adapter, which is of maximum 12 volt supply. Here, this is the servo motor. A servo motor is actually an assembly of 4 things: a normal DC motor, a gear motor, a reduction unit, a position sensing device and a control circuit. So above this DC motor, there is a mount, there's an ultrasonic sensor mounted on it. So this ultrasonic sensor emits an ultrasound at 40,000 Hertz, which travels through the air, and if there is an object or obstacle on its path, it will bounce back to the module.
Servo motor connections are medium.
and the ultrasonic sensors are connections are here.
Hello everyone, I am Shreedhar Soni and I am here to tell you in brief about the code that we use for developing the Arduino self-driving obstacle avoiding car. Step 1. Before uploading the code, you must include the necessary libraries, which are AF Motor library, Newping library and Servo libraries, which could be easily downloaded from GitHub. Then include those libraries in your main code. Next, the next step would be to define the constraints and create the objects. Then, since every Arduino code contains two functions, which are void setup and void loop functions. In void setup functions, we define the pin number, the critical distance at which the car stops, after which the car stops moving, and the angle of turning of the ultrasonic sensors. In void loop function, we write the code which is used repeatedly by ourselves. In void loop function, if distance becomes less than or equal to the critical distance, the car would stop moving and would turn backward. Then, the ultrasonic sensor would turn left and turn right to measure the distances on the left and the right and on the right side of the car. Then, if the distance on the right is greater than distance on the left, the car would turn right and start moving. Else, the car would turn on the left and start moving. Otherwise, the car would move forward. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I am Varun Dev and I will continue with the code. The next function is look right. The servo motor is initially at an angle 115 degree. After the car stops, we will give it a command to go at an angle 40 degree right. That is my servo right 40. After that, it will wait for 5 milliseconds and measure the distance between the next obstacle and the car and goes to its initial angle, that is 115 degrees. The next function is lookright function. It is same as lookright function. The only difference is in lookright function, the servo motor goes at an angle 40 degrees, and in lookright function, the servo motor will go at an angle 190 degrees to measure the distance between the next obstacle and the car in the left direction. After measuring both the distances, the direction in which the distance is smaller, the car will turn in that direction. For that, we have two functions, turn left and turn right. In turn right function, the tire 2 and 3 will move in backward direction, and the tire 1 and 4 will move in forward direction to turn the car in right direction. And in turn left function, these two tires will move in backward direction, and these two will move in forward direction to turn in the left direction. And after turning the car, it will start in moving forward. If the distance between car and the next obstacle is less than 20 cm in both the directions, right or left, the next function is called is move backward, in which the car will move 20 cm backward and then stops. After the car stops, the function will return the value and the look right and look right function will be called again. Thank you.